All right, start.
Hello, we are the Artificial Intelligence Group.
Hi, my name is Aina.
Hi, my name is Sonal Mahajan.
Hi, my name is Jiyu Kim.
Hi, my name is Irene Chen.
Do you realize that we use AI every single day of our lives? Well, for example, your fingerprint scanner that you use to unlock your iPhones. And even some cars can self-drive. These examples of AI are just the beginning. And automatic cars and other vehicles will be normal in the future. And even your daily going to the supermarket will be managed by AI.
Well, let's get going then. Today we are going to be talking about how AI works, the effects of AI, and how AI will look like in the future.
Our central idea is the improvement of AI impacts us and our society. These are our lines of inquiry. The first one is the effect of AI to our society. Second one is types of robots and technology. The third one is different roles of AI and technology. And last but not least, our fourth one is how AI works. Now we will be talking about what AI does. How do robots learn to recognize an image? Well, let's find out. On this, On this page, there are plants. Who wants to volunteer for this activity?
Lisa.
Lisa can volunteer.
Can you come up?
Yeah. So, can you go to the screen and can you point out the flowers for me?
Yeah, it might seem obvious, but
flower,
you don't
flower.
Care.
Flower.
Okay, so can you tell me why you chose those?
Because these are that's a leaf, mm-hmm. and that's a tree with lots of leaves in it.
And can you tell me like about
like the, describe why you chose like
yeah,
this
describe the flowers and
because they're labeled as flowers. I mean like. Flowers.
Like what, do they have petals and
hybrids? Oh yeah, they have petals and some of them have pollen and they have colorful colors except for that one.
Okay, thank you. So as you can see, when we're programming robots, we can't list, there's so many properties of, for example, in this case, flowers. So if you want a robot to recognize a flower, then we just keep on feeding images of flowers, like thousands and ten thousands of images of flowers. And then unlike humans, since robots can remember and store all the images into their brains in seconds, it can just learn by itself. And that's how it can recognize an image.
Next up is speech recognition. Speech recognition allows AI to mimic the way humans talk, and also this requires AI to have advanced technologies, as it can do, requires high social intelligence, and the ability to come up with an idea. Speech recognition should be programmed into advanced technologies, so it can talk in many different ways.
How can computers always win with games like chess against you? The answer is because while it plays thousands and thousands of games with people, it learns what to do in certain situations. You might wonder, like, how does it learn by itself without any programming? Well, there are steps that makes AI learn and win against people. First, they learn how people play. And next, they do computer simulation. In other words, they do AI versus AI. And finally, they fight against human player when they are ready.
This is actually the steps that AlphaGo, the AI which won the world champion of Go, took.
Moving on, do you use your computer or device for entertainment? Going deeper into that, have you ever played a game against a computer which would just never lose? Well, I will be explaining how a simple game of tic-tac-toe works. So, now suppose you're the computer. The first step is to know where are you going to place your tick. And the where is the part where the AI comes in. What the AI does is that it first sees that, like, this is the algorithm it uses. It looks at which position will give it the most amount of partially filled winnable rows. A winnable row is a row which does not contain any of the opponent's ticks in it. So this is how the tic-tac-toe game works. And this function is called the heuristic function. So do you use Google search engine? Well then, you probably have experience using predictive search. Predictive search uses AI to autocomplete or give suggestions for other relevant searches. This AI does this by looking at your past searches, your hobbies, your interests, your current location, and much more information. This enables your searches to not only be very convenient, but to also be efficient and productive. So, how about simulating the human brain using computers? Can we make computers work similar to the human brain? That is done using artificial neural networks. Artificial neural networks are designed to work similar to the human brain. An interesting facet of these systems is that they are very unpredictable in their self-learning. Some become very great problem solvers, whereas others don't perform as well. For training, in order to train them, several thousand cycles of interaction happen when the AI actually talks to the human and does interactive things to be able to solve problems in our world. And artificial neural networks are used for a wide variety of tasks, such as computer vision and speech recognition, that are hard to solve with regular rule-based programming.
Now we will explain about effects of AI.
So there are some times that AI could be dangerous or can harm us. For example, AI will take over our jobs. After visiting Accenture for a field trip, we learned that AI will take over most of our jobs in the future. Some of the jobs that might be taken over by AI is telemarketers. Additionally, there is already some jobs that is led by the AI. One of the examples is a hotel in Japan called Henna Hotel, where it's only using AI. Henna Hotel is the first ever hotel that is led by AI. Another example where AI can be dangerous is when we overuse AI, which means that humans will start losing some skills such as oral computation and become more and more dependent on machines.
How do you think we should manage AI? Some of the ways we can manage AI is, if we ever have AI robots, we do not use them as violence, life risk, and harming. We should have some safeguards to protect people from such risks. We shouldn't use AI for people's dignity, humanity, or privacy. These standards should be made at a company, an industry, a society, a country, and a global community. Now I'm going to be talking about the positive effects of AI. There are certain types of AI that could help us in our everyday lives, such as transportation, house cleaning, and communication. Also, more advanced technology uses in buses, taxis, trains, and cars that are led by AI, which can improve the way we commute to different places.
So now we're going to explain about AI in the future.
So on this page, I would like to explain more about AI in the future and how the world will look like with AI. Firstly, according to Chaiman Whiteson, people will also be like AI and they will be cyborgs. Humans might also be like AI in the future. Another claim that was made about AI is that according to Stuart Russell, AI can help us with reading complicated and long texts and synthesizing all the information which will be used in important texts. Now I will be talking about more inventions using AI. Some of the inventions will be self-driving cars, artificial intelligence delivery men, and you might be able to see robots walking on the street just like human beings. Every expert thinks differently about the future of AI. What do you think the society will look like in the future?
So next, I would like the audience to take a vote on this question on menti.com. Will AI pass human intelligence? So please take out your computer.
They won't really do it.
Okay. So suppose you voted. Thank you for voting. So this question, will AI pass human intelligence? This question is such a difficult question to answer. Well, according to an expert that I interviewed once on a field trip at Accenture, he said that there is no right or wrong answer. In other words, it means that nobody can predict exactly what will happen in the future of AI. It's just that there are so many possibilities, and the chances are it's mostly a yes, based on how far we have come compared to, say, 100 years ago. To conclude, AI has many positive qualities and negative qualities that humans may benefit from. We can help people understand the positive aspects of AI by informing them with accurate information and making sure we are creating AI machines with a genuine intelligence. Although, if we do not be careful, the more advanced AI may make humans' lives more difficult. We could still hope for a brighter future if we focus on the positive aspects of AI living amongst us. Thank you for listening.